avoid division collision.
Use your jabs, use your leg kicks, your body runner's kicks, and we'll tire them out. Ready. That's what will happen.
Ready, fight.
Round one is upon us between two of the best fighters in this division. Hard to find anything resembling a glaring weakness on either side when you break down the film.
There are no weaknesses in these guys. These guys are as well-rounded as they come. They both can wrestle, both can grapple, both can strike. They can do it all. And these are the matchups that we dream of as MMA fans. Nice, straight punch.
Beautiful combination there.
Yeah, he's mixed it all up.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Nice right hand.
Leg kick. These guys throwing early. Lunch right hand is true. All right, he engages in a single collar tie.
When you're in the clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head.
Straight right hand now just misses. Cannoneer gets tagged with a kick now. Let's see if he can rally. And they separate. Block there.
What a punch. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Glancing right hand lands upstairs. Oh, big elbow. Oh! Tried to go to the body, but unable to connect.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body.
That shot blocked by Cannoneer.
We need these points. Takedown.
Oh, big right hook, but a whiff.
Oh.
Too reckless. Too reckless.
That is a cut blade.
And he connects there.
I don't want to replace. Kind of near much. He's a good player, this guy. I'm making some stupid mistakes, he's capitalizing. One side, he's doing
it.
You ready to fight? You ready?
Second round here. There he goes, attacking that lead leg to the outside. Nasty kick there.
Nasty leg kick. You gotta slow down your opponent. He knew his opponent wanted to move a lot tonight. This is the first step. It's getting him to slow down and fight at your pace. Caught that. Now, there's danger in that, too, because when you start reaching down to catch that kick, you're about to high kick, and then you're in a lot of trouble. Loaded up.
His opponent's really on the ropes.
His opponent's on Beach Street. He's hurt so bad. I don't know what he's gonna do to stay in this fight. Oh, he hurt badly, jab.
You got this, okay? You got it.
Way to hide that leg kick. Nice punch lands over the top.
Visibly limping here. Back and forth we go here.
You can really limit the mobility of your opponent with those leg kicks.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike
focus,
lands there.
Focus.
Oh!
That shows the power
Yeah, of course.
Mixing everything up.
There you go. Look for the shot.
Just out of range with that strike.
Move and recover. Move and recover.
Looks like his leg is lifting a little bit.
I love the clinch. Right hook finishes it. That's a good fight as well, competitive.
It could be a short night for his opponent, but that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. And the rest, as they say, is history.
Scored him. Respect him for picking cannon near that, just yeah. Like kicks and strike kickboxing.
Perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time.
Ladies and gentlemen,
did you guys enjoy that fight? I've never heard, by the way. It's interesting.
It's a UFC fight heavyweight division collision.
I need to start reading a book before I go to bed now. Because yeah, when you wake up and all you do is play games and this and that, it just hurts your eyes so much.
You ready to fight?
Really does. I can see the lasting damage it does. How is this guy season 9 but level 20? Yeah, that shocks me.
Well, these guys have been on each other's radars for quite some time. Tonight, it shall be done. Both guys well-rounded. You think we're getting kickboxing matches tonight or what?
You just don't know, right? You don't know who's going to be able to deploy their strategy the way that they need to. It's a close fight on paper, and also in every tournament we have seen them put on, these guys seem to be the mirror image of each other.
Really timing his shots nicely, good tempo, very accurate, finding the range with relative ease.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of really overwhelming his opponent with activity. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Big knee to the body! Some of the damage caught underneath that right eye.
You're good.
Oh, how about this kicking game on full display tonight?
Kicks back to back, truly mixing up the target. Tight to hold.
Nice defense there. Huge block.
Oh. An uppercut landed.
Both guys landing at a pretty decent clip. Connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
He loaded up on that right hand too.
Oh, nice job with the knee strike there. That'll wake you up.
He thought it would be available. He just knew he had to find the right time to go with that. With the right time. Big punch land over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? It's very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Left hook to the head.
Come on.
His opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up. But he's not going to be on the receiving end of those nice strikes.
Massive head kicks. Just out of. Nice liver shot.
Any wish quit? Thank you very much. Thanks for rage quitting. That was really necessary, wasn't it?
This glove is more balanced.
You ready? You ready?
Alright, so here we go. Round one. I can barely hear myself thinking this arena right now. Two of the most dominant, well-rounded fighters in this division.
I mean, these guys are the best of all of mixed martial arts. They do everything when they're locked inside of the octagon. I'm so excited to watch the highest level of MMA on display tonight.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this young man.
Shera gets caught with that punch. Ooh, tagged him with the uppercut. All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you pull. He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Ooh, out of the star.
Shoot for the takedown here.
Front kick's gonna miss.
Just over 3 minutes to go in our first round. Trying to establish that jab once again. Nice right hand. Keep
going.
Oh, double leg takedown. And a nice job to stick with it there to complete the takedown. His opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. The crowd and pound is on point.
This match transition. Nice, got it.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any.
26 total strikes have now landed for Glover Teixeira. Nice punch there by Teixeira. Oh, big hook. That'll spin. Jab by him there. He's going nose hunting tonight, huh?
Yeah, he's great with the jab. Not only as a setup, really is trying to get damage off every time he throws his punch. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Oh, there's that patented right hand from Glover Teixeira, DC. Not a guy that you faced at 205 pounds. Certainly, though, a guy that was on your radar, and rightfully so.
Yeah, he fixed it all up. And it was perfect. It was absolutely perfect, John. Great place for the ball.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. 20 seconds to go in round one. All right, half guard position here, DC. You have an extra pop in your step when you talk about fighters working out of this half guard.
Oh, man. I like half guard as a top fighter. Don't want to be there.
He wants me to mimic him. Yeah, he's a good player.
If you are there, you have to be winning the position of the underhook. It opens up so much.
Everybody got to fix up in round two.
Ready?
He's got good grappling, not a leap. But
all right, let's go. Round two. Round.
Yeah, I was trying to.
Teixeira gets tagged with a kick now. Let's see if he can rally. Right, throws a straight punch and lands. The straight punches we've seen all night.
Huge straight punch lands, and he's got him hurt very bad.
Well, he has landed.
Oh, he's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh! Oh!
Bro, can I just not get it?
Yeah, he's moving in slow motion. He's throwing everything at his opponent, and he couldn't get him out of there. Now it's just a matter of trying to survive and not get knocked out himself. This might be the biggest shot of this entire fight. He landed a massive hook to put his opponent on wobbly legs.
Takedown attempts starting to pile up. Well, he's really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive now here and starting to find himself in the pocket. And so 65 total strikes have landed for
Glover Teixeira.
With 45% accuracy tonight against Glover Teixeira.
Great punch, man.
Hammer fist. Teixeira's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling.
Good job, you got my back.
Oh, how about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the
bottom. Yeah, most people don't know how to deny that.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
Nice job of hiding that head kick.
Oh my god.
Huge kick to the leg.
Get around.
Right, man, strikes.
Why is this fight so back and forth?
Now look back at some of the action from that round. He went headhunting, landed, nearly got the finish too.
A lot of coaches tell you don't headhunt.
God damn it, why is racket so hard to use? He feels slow even though it's stats 92 and stuff, but don't understand.
Crowd fired up, so are we. Third and final round.
You don't know when that leg kicks coming.
And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from.
Boxing.
Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Just missed with the left there. Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of... Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Won't finish the fight.
Oh! Oh!
Moving my head well.
Now he's on top of him looking for the finish. Oh, he got a match!
No.
Oh, really nice work to keep busy off of his back as he lands some more offense here for Bob. So inside the open guard of his opponent, you gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent.
Let's just focus on getting up. I don't want to mess with Glover's grappling.
All right, he's hanging out inside the closed guard.
Yes, they heard him in the last round. Same exact one.
Teixeira gets caught with that punch. His chin is held up thus far. Gotta shore up the defense here, though. I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he doesn't know where he is. He's hurt real bad. That punch
did. God damn it.
Trying to pass the guard here. Nice job by the bottom fighter defense.
Bottom fighter did a fantastic job of following with his hips, making sure he blocked any attempt to get past his guard.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. All right, some pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
Oh, yeah, he's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage.
All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. Gets up again here, but...
Beautiful finish. Oh my god.
He's done. He's done.
Oh my god, what a good fight. That is fun.
I'm not sure if that's the way he drew it up, but a huge result for him here tonight as he gets the win by way of knockout. And that's about as good a one strike finish as we've seen in recent memory. I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming.
What a beautiful finish.
Big win for him here tonight.
Look at that finish, the Muay Thai collision.
Bruce Buffer now has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 58 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout, Alexander Rockhand.
Well, he's smiling ear to ear, and why not after a knockout like that? I need to take it to the after party tonight.
I mean, this is what dreams are made of.
Great fight. Pretty fun fight. I got him better. Throw less strikes. Accuracy was good, but still, I felt I wish I threw less.